Welcome back. Of course, all eyes are on the tropics. Let's get back to CBS4 meteorologist Lissette Gonzalez, who has been working so hard. I know we were texting all weekend, keeping track of where Laura is going.
Yeah, you know, it's been a really scary situation, especially at the beginning of last week when we had that cone that was pointed directly at us. And of course, then we see how things can change very quickly. Mother Nature throws a curveball. All of a sudden, we have a strong ridge of high pressure. And that's really what's kept Laura moving here towards the west and northwest. And the fact that it has interacted with some of the islands early on, especially Puerto Rico, unfortunately, where they did have to deal with some heavy rain and flooding, as well as in Dominican Republic and Haiti. And now Cuba is getting slammed with heavy rain and gusty winds and flash flooding, as well as Grand Cayman and Jamaica. And although Laura is expected to stay well to our south, we've been feeling the effects here in South Florida, which is another reason why we always remind you to not just focus on that cone. Tropical storm warnings continue for much of Cuba and the middle and lower Keys. And the reason being is that you can see tropical storm conditions indicated by the yellow extend well out and away from where the center is expected to be later today, likely on the western tip here of Cuba as we head into the evening when it makes its closest approach. So as we head throughout the afternoon and evening here in South Florida, and that pressure gradient tightens up, and we see the winds will be increasing even more so. So hold on to your umbrella. We're dealing with some fast moving rain bands too. Laura's forecast to become a category one as we head into tomorrow, and then eventually category two on Wednesday before it makes landfall somewhere along the Louisiana or Texas coastline. Still a category one possibly into Thursday. So really a terrible situation here for friends along the Gulf Coast, which will also be dealing with Marco, and then eventually Laura is going to move off to the north and east. But Marco is arriving first later today and expected to be a tropical storm, hence a tropical storm warning is in place here for Mississippi as well as the Louisiana coastline. And it is moving to the west here and expected to continue moving westward. So dangerous storm surge, heavy rain, flooding will be possible for Mississippi through Louisiana and Texas. And already we're seeing some nasty weather too across the panhandle of Florida because it's a lopsided tropical storm. But as we take a look, you can see, some active weather for parts of the panhandle and the Gulf Coast states. And also Cuba, as I mentioned, Grand Cayman dealing with the deepest convection and the heaviest thunderstorm. So we have Marco arriving first today. And then before you know it, a few days later, Laura is making landfall as a category two or possibly stronger hurricane. Now, in terms of our impacts, tropical storm force wind gusts, 40 to 50 miles per hour, peak winds this afternoon. As I mentioned, some gusty squalls, fast moving rain bands, water spouts, and tornadoes possible right now.